Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have another great Silhouette Studio tutorial. Today we are going to break apart a design for layering.
Okay guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and we have this really cute little gnome holding the heart, and he is just the most adorable thing you've ever seen, right? Now the question becomes, this is a layered design, and do you want to layer one color on top of another? And that can be a complicated question because it is super easy to leave this design this way. And let me show you why. If I ungroup, okay, I have all these individual pieces. And I say that it's easy because having this black outline, it really will kind of fill in any gaps that happen to come across when you're lining it up. So having the black outline is what a lot of designers will do because it's kind of your fail safe. So when you're trying to line this up and you're layering it, you have the black outline there to be your little safety blanket. Okay. And then if things don't line up correctly, you just see a little bit more or a little bit less of the black instead of white or gray or whatever color you're putting this on. So there's a lot of really good reasons why you would want to leave it this way. Now, what I'm here to tell you is that with certain projects like heat transfer vinyl, sometimes when you layer heat transfer vinyl, number one, you're using materials that can't be layered, such as holographic, or most glitters are not supposed to be layered for heat transfer vinyl, also certain types of metallic. And in those situations, you would need to go ahead and be able to subtract out so that you're not layering these designs. In addition, there's a lot of benefits to not layering in that your designs will not peel as quickly. So for example, I made a shirt for myself a couple years ago. It has held up really great in the wash. I'm very happy with it. But now the areas that are peeling on the shirt, because let's face it, guys, vinyl isn't meant to last the next 20 years. I mean, it has a lifespan. But the areas that are peeling now are the parts of the vinyl that are layered on top of other vinyl, whereas the parts that are adhered straight to the fabric of the shirt are still there. And one last tip for why you would want to break apart your design for layering is that sometimes when you have too many layers, it really gets bulky, which can also be a pain depending on the type of project you're working on. And I think it makes your shirt especially heavy if you're using a lot of layered vinyl on apparel. Okay, so lots of great reasons why you would either want to leave this layered or why you would want to break it apart. It just depends on where you're at in your crafting journey and also your ultimate goal for your project. Now, if I was just going to layer on top of the black, then I would select my light colors. I could group those together. You can select more than one color, or rather, you can select more than one shape by holding down your shift key when you click. So then I could simply break this apart and cut it in all its individual pieces, okay? But what we're going to do is we're actually going to subtract out these colors so that we have a black outline, and then we have shapes that fill in the gaps in the black outline. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I will group this entire design together, and I will create a duplicate. Now you can use copy and paste. On your keyboard, you can also use control and your left arrow. And really it's any arrow, but I tend to use my left arrow. And I'm just giving myself a starting place of my original design. Now this is really super easy. I'm gonna right click, and I'm gonna choose make a compound path. And that is literally all I have to do. Now I have a black outline. Let's go ahead and this one we will ungroup and we will delete the black outline here. And all these pieces will fit nice and snug into my new design. Now, say this was a design that you could not use the make a compound path trick, all right? Because not every design will you be able to do that. What you would then want to do, here, let's undo, let's go all the way back. That's where your subtract is going to come into play. So I still go color by color, but I would select, this is my drag box, so I'm holding down the mouse key, and I'm going to select the black and the red and hit subtract. And then I just, like I said, I do it color by color, select the beige and the black and subtract. I can do the same with the gray. Well, I guess we want to do white first. You can't see the white, but it is there. Subtract out the white and subtract out the gray. Now, I know in this circumstance, you're saying, Becky, I don't see a whole lot of difference, but there will be designs where you will only need to subtract out part of your design instead of subtracting out the entire selection like this where you have an outline. So just keep that in mind. Make a compound path when you have a design like this, but if it doesn't yield you the results that you need, then go ahead and use that undo button and use the subtract tool on the pieces that you need to subtract, okay? So now we would be able to do the same thing. I'm just going to ungroup and I can delete that black outline and this will fit right in here. There we go. And guys, that is the process of subtracting out your design so that you can have all of your colors on one layer. So you're turning a multi-layer design into one solid layer just in case you're using materials that can't be layered or you want to get your project as flush with your shirt or blank as you need to.
So guys, how did you feel about breaking apart your design in Silhouette Studio for layering? Now I know it's one of those things that, hey, not everybody wants to get behind. If you want to layer one color on top of another, that is perfectly fine. But what I want you to do is just keep this tutorial in mind. And the next time you're working with a project that either you don't want to layer or you're using materials that can't be layered, feel free to come back and check it out again, okay? Because, you know, it's just one of those things that you don't need it until you need it. But hopefully we were able to teach you a few things today. And this will be something that you can reference for one of your projects in the future. Of course, if you have any questions or comments about what we've done today, please make sure you leave those below. I do absolutely love to hear from you guys. And if you don't mind, take a minute to subscribe to the channel. Make sure you turn on notifications for all of our new videos. And guys, I really appreciate you stopping by. It really means a lot to me when you pay me a visit. And I'm going to wrap it up, but we will see you next time.